Rajiv, good morning. How can I run and, if necessary, troubleshoot DIP?
Good morning, Matt. I'd be happy to help. Let me share my screen.
Thanks, Rajiv.
Running DIP is a fairly straightforward process. To start, we'll head over to the OnBase client, processing, and DIP. Then we'll right-click on our process, then hit Document Import Processor. Before we run the process, we have the option to test the process. So we'll go ahead and do that. So now that the test has returned clean, I'll go ahead and run the process. Now, if we head over to awaiting commit and go into DIP checks, we'll see all of our imported documents with the correct keywords. If we go back into awaiting commit, we'll also have the option to commit the documents to all copies of our disk groups if needed. Next, let's go over some troubleshooting tips that may help resolve some common DIP issues. First, it's great practice to ensure that the workstation is licensed for DIP. This can be checked in the OnBase client, admin, user management, workstation registration. Next, we also want to ensure that the user group has rights to the correct document type that we're importing in this DIP process. We also want to ensure that the user group has product rights for client and DIP. And of course, we'll want to make sure that the user group has the privilege to retrieve and view. Now in the settings of the DIP process, we want to ensure that the index file also exists correctly in the specified directory. To troubleshoot, it would also be best to verify that settings for the field type, separator, and delimiters are all correct according to your index file. It also may be worth checking if the field configuration aligns correctly with your index file as well. And lastly, we of course want to ensure that the user has write access to the index file itself and the appropriate disk group.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to hit that subscribe button and give us a thumbs up. If you have a question that you would like answered on an upcoming question corner, please leave a comment below.